Hello, my name is John Kelly, and this is the Weber Auto YouTube channel. Today, we are going to learn how to check the fluid level, transmission fluid level, on the ZF or ZF 8-speed automatic transmissions that are used in Chrysler products, BMWs, other vehicles. I'll use these 8-speed automatic transmissions. And these transmissions take a unique fluid. I purchased this fluid today from the local Chrysler dealer. This is the 8 and 9 speed automatic transmission fluid, and it's kind of hard to see. Let me hold up a white paper behind it here, but it's kind of a green tint, kind of a dark green tint automatic transmission fluid. It is not your red ATF4 that Chrysler transmissions have used in the past. This is a special automatic transmission fluid. The price on this is around $43 a quart. So you want to be real careful with this fluid. Make sure you don't waste it. But what we have here today to check the transmission fluid level on is a 2013 Chrysler 300C with a 3.6 liter engine. It has the 8 HP45 transmission. If you get a Chrysler, a Dodge Ram pickup truck with the 8-speed, you'll probably have the 8 HP70. And if you get the like a HellCat, it has the 8 HP90. And then other vehicle manufacturers use these same transmissions in rear-wheel drive, all-wheel drive configurations. Seems to be a pretty neat transmission. But it has a unique transmission fluid level checking procedure that I want to take you through today. And so if we look at the bottom pan here of the transmission, we have a drain plug right here. And on the side of the transmission pan, right here in orange letters, let me zoom in so you can see the orange sticker with the yellow letters. That sticker tells us that we need to use the proper fluid that I've already shown you. We need to check the transmission fluid level with this plug that is directly above the sticker. So the plug is right here. We need to check the fluid level by removing that plug when the transmission fluid temperature, as read on a scan tool, is between 86 degrees Fahrenheit and 122 degrees Fahrenheit. That's also 30 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. If you check it when it's hotter than that, the fluid will have expanded and you will definitely have fluid come out of the plug, and you will now drain, that would have drained fluid out of the transmission, causing it to be underfilled. So we have to check this fluid at the proper temperature. There's a 3-page procedure right from Chrysler's Dealer Connect service information website for checking the fluid level on this trans. And so I want to go through this procedure and then show you an additional thing that this procedure didn't tell you about that will definitely affect the fluid level of the transmission that you need to be wary of. So a fluid level checking procedure has us raise the vehicle on a hoist, a level hoist, so that the transmission fluid will be level with the hoist itself. Now it tells us to start the engine. We're not going to start it yet. Before we start the engine, let me read a couple of more steps here. If it's an all-wheel drive vehicle, we have to remove the front prop shaft to access this plug, but this is a rear-wheel drive, so that doesn't apply. We need to hook up a scan tool and verify that the transmission fluid temperature is lower than the 86 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, so I've got a scan tool set up over here on this cart behind me. And if I zoom in here, transmission oil temperature reads 79 degrees. So 79 degrees, we are below the 86 degrees. If we start with the fluid temperature too high, we will run out of time as we go through the fluid level checking procedure. That will cause the fluid to heat up faster than we want it to, and we will exceed the 122 degree Fahrenheit maximum. And so we want to start this fluid level checking procedure basically on a cold vehicle, one that has not been started yet. So this is not something you're going to do during a lube oil and filter. It's got to be a special procedure to do this. Okay, so we're going to start the engine here in a minute. We're going to pull this plug out of the side of the transmission, and if any fluid comes out, then we'll just catch that fluid in a drain pan. If no fluid comes out, then it tells us to add fluid until it does come out. So what this procedure, or what this step does, is it adds enough fluid to make sure that it's safe to even perform the rest of the fluid level check procedure. All right, I'm going to loosen the plug first. It takes an 8mm Allen wrench to loosen it. All right, go ahead and start it up. Just let it idle. All right, so I'm going to take that plug out. All right, I've removed the plug. No fluid has come out, so that tells us that it's too low to even begin with. And so I'm going to add fluid. So the procedure tells us to add fluid to the transmission until some fluid comes out. So let me get positioned to do that. I've put a flexible hose on the top of the transmission fluid bottle, and I'm going to add fluid here. This transmission is definitely low. I'm going to add some more. Oh, there we go. Okay, so we've got fluid coming out. As you can see, it's dripping out of the side here. That tells us that we've got enough fluid in there now to continue with the fluid level checking procedure. So we put the plug back in. All right, the next step, we've lowered the vehicle now for the next step of the fluid level checking procedure. It tells us to disable the traction control. Then, with the brakes applied, put the transmission into reverse and hold it for 5 seconds. And then put it in drive and hold it for 5 seconds. And then let off the brakes and slowly accelerate to second gear, and then hold it for 5 seconds in second gear. Okay, apply the brakes and put the transmission in neutral. Now raise the engine speed to 2,000 RPM for 5 seconds. All right, come back to idle, transmission in park. And now we got to put the vehicle back up on the hoist, pull that plug back out of the side, and if fluid drains out, then it had too much fluid in it. If no fluid comes out, then we need to add fluid. Right now, our transmission fluid temperature is 90 degrees. So we don't want to exceed 122. So we're at 90. Okay, we've got the vehicle back up on the hoist. We've kept the engine running. We don't have a lot of time Our transmission fluid temperature is at 95 degrees, and we have up until 122. And this is kind of a cool day. If we would have started on a hotter day, that would have give us even less time. So now let's take the plug out. It tells us when we take it out, if there's any fluid that comes out, that it was too full, and just let it drain until it stops draining. Okay, so we're having fluid come out. We'll let it drain, and not until it totally stops, but until it gets down to a slow drip, drip, drip kind of drizzle. Fluid temperature's up to 97. All right, it looks like it's not gonna, oh, there we go. Okay, we're down to just a slow drip right there. Put the plug back in. We'll come back and torque that spec here later. Okay, now, supposedly, we're done. Go ahead and shut it off. So that is the official Chrysler service information on checking the fluid level on these 8-speed transmissions. But there's more, a little more to it than that. And I learned about another issue that affects the fluid level on this. At an Automatic Transmission Rebuilders Association conference last year in Las Vegas, there was a guy from ZF Transmissions that spoke about these 8-speeds, and he was telling us that a lot of vehicles have a transmission cooler thermostatic bypass valve that when the fluid level is cool enough to check, this bypass valve is open. And what that means is that there's no fluid going through the transmission cooler at this low temperature. And so I looked up the transmission cooler system on this vehicle, which is found under cooling rather than transmission. And it turns out the automatic transmission fluid cooler is part of the air conditioning condenser. It's the top several rows of tubes across the air conditioning condenser. So it's in front of the radiator, which is actually pretty good. It gets cooler air than if it were in the radiator itself. But in between that transmission cooler and the transmission is this thermostatic bypass valve. And I looked to see where it is located. Let me show that to you. Okay, so right here under the front suspension system, we've got the right and left tires here. I've removed the engine undercover, and right to the left-hand side of the engine oil pan, right up here is the thermostatic or temperature sensitive cooler bypass valve. So that block of aluminum right here, these two lines right here are coming from the transmission. They're just going to take a U-turn when the transmission fluid temperature is below 160 degrees Fahrenheit. And then once it's above 160, it'll open up and allow fluid to go forward to the transmission cooler up in the air conditioning condenser. So what does that mean for your automatic transmission fluid level check that we just did? That level check that we just performed was done with this cooler bypass valve open. So that fluid level is incorrect because there's no fluid going through the cooler. The cooler lines, and these are some pretty good diameter pipes, and the condenser is pretty wide. It looks to me like that would hold a lot of fluid. And there's several things to consider when we're talking about that cooler bypass valve. One, of course, is your fluid level. If that whole system had drained when it was previously hot and drained back into the transmission, and now it's fairly empty, when it finally does open at 160 degrees, then your fluid level in the transpan is going to be too low. So that's another thing to consider. So that means that you're going to want to set the level with it cool, then go drive it, get it nice and hot, let this thing open up, let this cooler bypass valve open up, and then let it cool down again, and then check the fluid level again, just to make sure that you got all the air out of the system, especially if you've had the system open, or if you've removed the transmission, you've overhauled it or whatever, or replaced it. You could have a lot of air in there that is going to affect your transmission fluid level. Also, of course, if you had a transmission failure, and you've changed the transmission, and you haven't flushed the cooler by disconnecting the pipes at the front of this thermostatic cooler bypass valve, then you're still going to have all that rotten fluid up in the transmission cooler that as soon as you put that new transmission in, warm it up to above 160, all that garbage is going to go back into your transmission on your cooling passages, your lubrication passages, gears, bearings, and of course ruin everything. So be aware, the guy from ZF said not every vehicle has this thermostatic bypass valve. Some of them it's built into as part of the transmission cooler. Other manufacturers have it on the transmission itself. Some manufacturers like Toyota have a method where you can push the valve to the closed position and force fluid through the cooler and lock it in place with a pin, but this one doesn't appear to have any method of forcing it to let fluid through the cooler while you're checking the transmission fluid level. So this actually could be a two-day process by the time you check it cold, let it warm up, let it cool back down, and check it again. And I don't see a shortcut. I don't see a way around that. So the fluid level checking procedure in the actual Chrysler service information tells you nothing about this cooler bypass valve here, and I'm positive that it will have an effect on the transmission fluid level. So this has been a demonstration of checking the transmission fluid level on the ZF or ZF 8HP series automatic transmissions. Thank you for watching.